everybody. Welcome to the launch of me and my daughter's company, F.E.A.R. Female entrepreneurs are rock stars, and future female entrepreneurs are rock stars. I thank everybody for coming. I hope you guys enjoy your night and stay tuned. There's so much more we have in store. Thanks.
If y'all thought that was fun, I'm about to bring y'all a, like a Billie Holiday, Lena Horne. This lady killed. Like heaven. Put your hands up. And it's my girl, y'all, so I know she's about to kill.
So, very happy to be here. I cannot wait to work with that beautiful doll of a woman that just got through singing up here. So I'm excited about everything God is doing for you. I'm gonna sing this one song that I can wait to.
Party. Female entrepreneurs are rock stars. I want you guys to stay in tune for what we have coming up for 2016. Thank you.
Y'all know I'm Stacy's little brother. She's the one taught me everything I know. I want to thank her. That's it. That's what I got for her.
Amen.
Come on, Stacy.
Thank you all for coming tonight to support Stacy. I have so many things that I can say, but I won't embarrass her. Stacy is probably one of the most strategic people that I know. When I say strategic, I mean in the sense that she has a vision, she puts it into play, and then the result is whatever she foresaw it to be. From day one, with the hungriest rapper, what else did you do? She's done so many things, but the bottom line is, tonight is her night for the launch of her company, her and her daughter, and I just really appreciate all you guys coming to support her. I am so dead tired, excuse my appearance, but we love you, we're very proud of you, and you deserve everything that you get, and thank you for the remote starter for my car. So now I'm waiting on a new car. Okay, sis? Okay, thank you all for coming tonight, and
all right, everybody. now I have two special people that are coming up here. This is a shocker for her, because they never really wanted to get up and be put on the spot. So I'm gonna bring Stacy's daughter, little Breezy, and Breezy's father, Dante, to the stage. Yeah, I got them. I got them to come up here. She's been doing a lot. Like, she be yelling at me because of y'all. Like, for real, like, I get in trouble every day over this. And we have come so far, me and Chuck. So we have come so far. And I, like, really appreciate y'all. You know, I love my mom. And, like, when she wants something, she put, like, she really wants something. And she do it. So I want y'all to, like, clap for her because, like, she has been working really hard. And I love her too.
Well, for those that don't know me, I'm Breon's father. My name is Dante, also known as G7, the music Sabbath. That's irrelevant. This is about the daughter, the mother of my daughter. Just to give y'all a little history, you know, we want to let the record reflect that a lot of sacrifices were made on Stacy's behalf. To bring her vision into manifest. You know what I'm saying? I was there from day one. We got 25 calendars in it. You know what I'm saying? And it wouldn't have been able to happen if we weren't able to get on one accord and come together with an understanding of what was best for our child while she pursued her dream. You know what I'm saying? And only a friendship can build that type of understanding that goes beyond the intimacy, that goes beyond you know, just raising a child or just saying, baby mama, baby did. You know what I'm saying? It takes a real commitment to making something happen, to make a dream come true. You know what I'm saying? And for me, I was the person that really jumped out there years back and was trying to shake my moves with the music and made my mistakes and made my connections. And I fully believe that I gave her the inspiration to pursue her dream just by seeing me do what I did. You know what I mean? So to see her take it one step further and create an entrepreneurial opportunity, especially as a black woman, you feel? Because women get blackballed in the industry. I done seen it. I done been on all four corners of the map. And the sisters get treated. You know, if you ain't bold, if you ain't standing on your square and got a real vision and ready to stand down and fight and die for what you believe in, the brothers will really put you to the side. They'll play you. You know what I'm saying? She fight through it, but she a boss. Period, point blank. So, you know, in closing, I just want to say that I wish her nothing but success, you know what I'm saying, from the bottom of my heart, because I know that anything manifest through her is ultimately going to benefit my child, and she going to take that torch, and she going to run with that boy. I want to cuss, but I'm going to keep it PG. But it's all good, man. Y'all enjoy it, and I appreciate it.
Yes, yeah.
Let me bust a freestyle one time, though.
This is Chicago. All right,
everybody. Seems like everybody got a lot of good things to say about Breezy. So I'm gonna give y'all a little history about me and Breezy. Breezy is my friend, my sister, my ear, my arm, my leg. Sometimes her bank account. But no, Breezy is a very close friend of mine. We've been friends 13 years. And when you definitely say ride or die, I've seen this girl go from the bottom to the top, for real, for real. And she made a lot of sacrifices. I agree with you, Dante. She really did. Because it's not easy being a female trying to break out in the industry in so many different levels. It's not that easy. You get chopped down. It's a lot of like, what you doing, baby? They just think you're on garbage. And Breezy has definitely proved them wrong. So I love you, Breezy, from a part of the game all the way up until the new hip hop stage play coming soon, where I play Mama Elaine along with Miss Ebony Baker, along with Miss Tania. We are all in the building for the stage play that we are so proud of you. And I want to let you know, no matter what, you know, I got two sides. I'm not a Gemini, but I got two sides.
You call me on business, and you call me when I need to break a nigga neck. So, I love you, and congratulations. I'm proud of you, and I'm proud to be a part of this movement. We are here. Everybody give a round of applause.
So give yourselves a round of applause, okay? If you don't know me, I'll just give you a little background. So basically, I started Breezy Entertainment in May of 2009 with a vision. Like my daughter's father said, we've been friends for 25 years, and he's the reason that I even entered in the industry. You know, he got me involved in music, and I fell in love with it. So basically, I wanted to do something that represented my daughter, Breezy. My sister back there, Crystal, gave her the name Breezy because she used to rap, model, act, dance, do everything. She was on billboards, winning them, all type of modeling competitions. So we called her Easy Breezy Beautiful Cover Girl. And that's how Breezy stuck. And then when I got to the industry, I was known as Miss Breezy. I started out didn't know nothing. I was just in school getting my associate. And I decided to do something like, the Hungriest Rapper reality show. About 500 people came out auditioned. Valentino was one of the judges there, a couple other people, and I ended up giving out like $10,000 in cash and prizes. I was just trying to see where I fit in the industry. And then I realized that hip hop is where it's at out here in Chicago. So I started monitoring every artist out here locally to see what they do. I created a platform with a bunch of models. I managed over 50 models in Chicago, and I ended up having Breezy Diamond Dallas. And that's what took me to the top. I mean, we were at every celebrity event, every radio station. I mean, don't have to wait in line. We just blew up. I'm like, what is all this? And the way we got there is because I just watched different people, like artists online, and seeing what they do. And I just started taking their stuff and promoting it. And so they noticed me, and then they noticed my girls. And then they requested us at every event. And that's how we got known, because of the support that we gave to people in Chicago that is lacking out here. After that, the following year, I said, every year I'm gonna do something big. So in 2011, I produced a song called Chicago United, where we bring people together. It was 10 rappers and one singer. And we brought people together, almost like a We Are the World type of thing. And we premiered it at the movie theater and had a huge success. After that, my daughter came to me and was like, Mommy, you always naming everything after me, but we don't have nothing for kids. So I started the Performing Arts Academy in 2011. And we did it in Robbins Park District. So we had kids and we taught theater, acting, dance, and then modeling. The following year, there was a lot of bullying and a lot of shooting and killing. So I did a foundation called All Kids Are Our Kids. And we did a Stop the Violence and Bullying school tour. After that, the next year, the next 2 years, I took a leave of absence to just clear my head. And then I came back strong with a movie called Part of the Game. That Valentino right here is, all of them. Majority of the kids here. Yeah. Huge success. We launched that last year, and you guys can go on YouTube. I actually just released it. I had a deal with Maverick Entertainment, but it wasn't what I was looking for, so I turned it down and learned a lot from it and what you need in this industry. But now I'm working on my next event, which is a hip hop stage play. So what I do every year is take something, a vision that I have, and do it big. And Breezy Entertainment is a company that provides a platform for upcoming talent and artists who needs to get out there. So if someone just happens to come to me and be like, you know what, Breezy, I hear you do a lot of things, whatever. Like, I always thought about getting active. And I know Coach Still and Leo D were two artists that was trying to break into acting. I created a movie out of it. And it became successful when I just started dealing with a bunch of other people and had them in it. And the same thing now is Miss Ebony Baker, she'll be playing the lead role in the movie, in the play. The name of the play is The Promise That Was Broken. She'll be playing Promise. Another girl is supposed to sing. She's in the hospital, unfortunately, so I hope she gets better. But Ashley, she'll be playing her best friend, Amari, which is my daughter's middle name. And then Trinikia, she'll be playing in the play also with Brandy back there. Like she said, she sang so beautifully at the auditions, but I had to create a part for her in the play. So that's how she ended up in the play. So that's the background of Breezy Entertainment, and then it led up to this year now where we're at with F.E.A.R. F.E.A.R. is called Female Entrepreneurs Are Rock Stars. I decided to do something with my daughter. She's 16 years old. And I've been doing so much stuff with adults because I know you have to get through the adults to get to the kids first, because adults are going to question, who are you, what do? Who do you know? So I took 7 years to build that reputation where I can make a phone call out in Chicago and almost get anything done that I need, the support that I've been giving to people. So now it's time to bring my daughter, and we launched F.E.A.R., Female Entrepreneurs Are Rock Stars, and her division is Future Female Entrepreneurs Are Rock Stars. So what it is our slogan is, behind every successful woman should be a group of women rooting her on. And I want to thank a couple of people that did the F.E.A.R. photo shoot, and I would kind of like y'all to come up real quick. China, yeah, I knew you were shaking your head. I saw that corner of my eye. China, Mimi is not here, but Sparkle, Brandy, my daughter, Naima, Red Red. I'm not gonna make y'all talk.
Okay, good.
Where's Brandy? Where is Naima? She was here.
I think she's outside.
But these girls, when I was getting ready to do the F.E.A.R. campaign photo shoot for my website, they supported me so much. Like, we worked together throughout the industry, and all of these women are entrepreneurs. They all have businesses. For example, her. This is her menu. Sparkle, this is one of my partners I had. She does everything in the industry, from management of artists to publicists, you can name a bunch of different things. Of course, my baby girl, who I'm raising up to take the footsteps of her mother. Who's that? Don't be high, all eyes on me. She was watching me when I launched my song that I had produced, whatever. She was there and she had to come with all eyes on you. So now it's the Red Radar. She's one of the hardest working women out here that I know too. So thank you for always supporting me, boo. Ride or die. Y'all know she don't need no introduction. She introduces herself, Brandy. She's my assistant along with Dwayne, but she's more like my right hand, my partner, ride or die. Wherever you see her, you're gonna see me. It's like two peas in a pot, because we always dress alike, look alike. Like, we was gonna have the same hairstyle. I'm like, who thinks of a hairstyle like this? Come on now. And she was really gonna go get the same hairstyle. We sent each other the picture. So it just, I love you guys so much, and I thank you guys for always supporting me, okay? Thank you. We offer network resources, mentorship. If you know a young teen or a young lady that's trying to come up in the industry, whether it's through singing, acting, dancing, modeling, rapping, DJing, beat production, hairstyling, makeup, anything you need, you can come to our company. We have mentors ready to help them. We have resources. We have different avenues of help. A lot of women they're afraid to get in the industry because of the fact that it's male-dominated. I was kind of like that. I know you see the shows Love and Hip Hop and stuff, and they feel like you got to sleep your way to the top. I refuse to be one of those statistics that have to do that to be able to get to where I am. Everything I've done, I work for. I have an associate's in liberal arts, a bachelor's in music business, a master's in entertainment business, and a second master's in public relations. I didn't have to sleep my way to get there. You know, so I'm trying to teach my daughter. She doesn't have to do that. The reason why I chose that slogan, behind every woman should be a group of women rooting them on, is I had an incident happen to me last year. Actually, two incidents that I've never spoke about publicly. You know, so you guys will be the first ones to hear about it, besides the folks that know. But I have such
many haters out here, I say, and I hate to say that, for reasons that I don't understand why, when all I've tried to do is support them. I mean, it has gone so far to the point that they called Fox 32 News to say I was running escort services, that I was followed by the FBI for 3 months and did not know that I'm a special education teacher for CPS and I almost lost my job. So once the legal department called me down, the lawyers, to say that they was investigating me, they found out what I really did and commended me and didn't understand why someone, some lady, would want to do that to me. Couple of months, about 6 months later went by. Everybody know I make peach cobbler. Y'all love my peach cobbler, right? So I had, what?
Did you bring some?
No, I ain't do all that though. But Big Mike Heroes wanted my peach cobbler in a restaurant. The day it launched is the day the same girl called there to say that I had food poisoning and just did all type of things to make it where I couldn't have my stuff in it. So that's why I say, like, there's no reason for us women to be out here hating on each other. That's why I really do appreciate those ladies that was up here that did support me, and the ladies sitting in the audience that has supported me. And some of you in this audience, I don't even know from Facebook, you know? So to know that you guys are here supporting me, it means so much, and I thank you. Also, the reason you notice a lot of things here are gold and black, and dressed in gold and black, me and my daughter. The reason why I chose those colors is black is the color of fear. And it's a hidden and unknown mystery when you think of black. And when people heard the word fear when I launched it online, I didn't say what it stood for until last week. So people were coming up with all types of things. They didn't understand why I named it fear. They thought it was scary. And a lot of people are scared to return to this industry. But gold is the color of success. It's the color of achievement, and it's the color of triumph. And I've overcome so many obstacles, you know, to be where I am today. And those are the reasons why me and my daughter decided to go with those colors, black and gold, to give everybody, you know, saying a chance to feel like they can support. Hello, come on in. Just like people, I'm acting like a comedian now. Come on in, we're gonna put you on the spot now. Where y'all been? But you can always see gold and black at our events, whatever. I want to real quick with everything, Shanikia and Ebony and Egypt for performing. I really do appreciate it. I know you were sick of the dog. I called y'all like she was not coming back in. So I appreciate you. Real quick, I need a little participation. I'm about to wrap it up a little bit. I need a little participation.
For Breezy Entertainment. And I just want to encourage all you women, it is never too late to do what you need to do. It is not an age, it is not a pace. You don't have to go fast. I'm 39, I just got in the game. And I'm going somewhere. I'm claiming and I'm speaking it out. So I ask all you ladies that's in this field to give y'all a round of applause, because it's not easy being a lady. It's not easy. But honestly, I wish everybody safe travel. I hope everybody enjoys the talent. I salute all of the people that perform tonight. You guys rock. Look for them. Look for them. Because you will definitely see them. My slogan for this year, for 2016, is that if God is working, there's no reason you shouldn't be. So everybody get on y'all toes, button up y'all seatbelts, and get ready for this ride. Because we are here. Good night. Thank you.